speaking this morning with Phil Hoskins from Evolution Energy Minerals. Phil, good morning.
Hi, Andrew. How are you going?
Yeah, good, Phil. Big updates from you this morning here. These landmark agreements have been settled with the government of Tanzania. Tell us a bit more about them, what the significance of them is.
Absolutely. It's a huge milestone for the company. And having been working on this project and in Tanzania for 9 years and having endured some pretty tough times from 2017 onwards with some of the changes in the mining legislation, what we've known and what our shareholders have known for some time is it's critical to secure a framework agreement to be able to, I guess, settle the fiscal terms associated with building this mine. It's something that's critical to the financiers to understand with certainty what the returns look like when debt can be repaid, and equally for our investors to know if additional equity is being invested, when that can be returned. And it's something we've worked on very hard, particularly in the last 18 months under the new president. And I've said this before, Tanzania is a different place. We've got excellent support from the top. She's set the direction, and the government negotiating team that we've been working with have been very open and transparent. But it's really pleasing to get to the end and have basically squared away where the agreements are at last week with the Attorney General and the government negotiating team. And I'll be heading back later this month to attend an official signing ceremony with the president. So yeah, it's a really good result.
And Phil, how's work on the updated DFS?
Yeah, we're a couple of weeks away. Yeah, obviously having the framework agreement resolved was something we wanted to sort out first. And I guess all those terms in that framework agreement were as we expected around taxes, royalties, free carried interest, the 16% to the government, and all of those things. But yeah, the DFS is due to come out in the coming weeks. Our expectation is, given its coarse flake graphite, that we're going to be continue to be a very high margin project. Even in the inflationary environment we're in, I'm expecting that our capital cost is going to be is low relative to peers and in a financeable position. So we're expecting the DFS to look really good. And then from there, they're the two key milestones that financiers have been waiting for. So yeah, that framework agreement and the DFS. With those in our back pocket, we've had a number of expressions of interest from debt providers, both African and international, and we'll be working through a process with an independent technical engineer running through that DFS, essentially the due diligence required to work towards credit approved term sheets from those banks. And after that, obviously, comes equity raisings and other things later this year. So, but yeah, you couldn't have two bigger milestones for the company than the framework agreement that we're now tucking away and the upcoming DFS.
Just remind us, where are you as far as offtake?
Yeah, so you'll recall that our coarse flake graphite or our deposit is largely coarse flake, and we've got a 30,000 tonne binding offtake agreement with YXGC, which is the global leader for expandable graphite and graphite foil. And those are maybe the lesser known real value adds for coarse flake. So that's where you want to be selling your graphite. Importantly, on the fines, we haven't yet contracted our fines under an offtake agreement. It's the fines that goes into lithium ion batteries. And the reason that that's important, I think, is that all the other development ready graphite companies have already partnered up with someone. There's a number of people out there that that haven't secured their fines, and a lot of them understand that they're going to need to undertake upstream investment to be able to secure those. So I think it's quite strategic that we've got them in place, and if we can, we'd like it to be leveraged into our own vertically integrated strategy to pursue downstream processing in the US. And it's a strategy that's gone very well for Syrah, and has seen US government funding and also Tesla offtake support. So I think it's quite strategic that we've still got our fines uncontracted for now.
And Phil, just finally, in terms of other news, we must be due some assays from your recent drill program.
Yeah, definitely. So it was close to 6,000 metres of RC drilling towards the end of last year. Obviously not required for financing, given we've got an 18-year mine life based on our reserves, but What we wanted to be able to do was to demonstrate the significant upside potential of the project. It's important for our customers to know that we can grow with their ever-growing needs. And those results will be coming through over the coming weeks. And I'm confident that they'll portray a situation where there's a hell of a lot of graphite on our tenements, and whether it's mine life extensions or an ability to expand production, that's definitely in the future for Evolution.
Good to speak, Phil. Thanks very much.
Thank you, Andrew.